Hello friends, in this video we are going to solve a numerical which is based on water hammer effect on another case than the gradual closure, that is on the sudden closure case. So let's see the video. Let's see the numerical. A wall is provided at the end of cast iron pipe of dia 150 mm. So value of dia is 150 mm. They are providing the data as cast iron pipe, so pipe is of metal, so it may be elastic case, and of thickness 10 mm. If this thickness is given to us, it clears that it is the case of sudden closure, so it is 10 mm thick. Water is flowing through pipe which is suddenly stopped by closing a wall. Yes, we know that already. Find the maximum velocity of water when rise of pressure due to sudden closure of wall is this one. This pressure is given to us in the unit Newton per centimeter square, and it is already given to us. So we don't have to calculate the pressure, but they are asking us to find maximum velocity. To calculate velocity, they have provided extra data as K for water as 19.62 into 10 raised to 4 Newton per centimeter square, and E for cast iron pipe as 11.772 into 10 raised to 6 Newton per centimeter square. So all the units are in Newton per centimeter square, so we don't have any need to convert them and waste our time. So it is better that we will use the same units and we will use the same formula for the calculations. So it is clear that we have to use formula as P is equal to V under root this rho upon 1 upon k plus d upon et bracket complete. Remember, this square root sign is for numerator as well as denominator. So P is given to us, we have to calculate rho. Rho is, we all know, for water it is 1000 kg per meter cube. K value is given to us, dia is given to us, E is given to us, T is also given to us. But the value of rho which is given to us is in kg per meter cube. Either convert it into centimeter cube or convert these remaining terms into centimeter cube. So we will basically convert all the units into meter cube. So P is equal to, pressure is given to us as 196.2 kg per centimeter square. So to convert centimeter square into meter square, we will have formula 196.2 into 10 raised to 4 kg per meter square. Most of the students have problems in these conversions. Remember the logic. If this square is of dimension 1 centimeter by 1 centimeter, then pressure acting on this much area is nothing but the 196.2 kg. This is the meaning of the term pressure. If we are increasing the area to the larger one, say 1 meter square, so in that case, it is obvious that more smaller units are involved like this. So the value of pressure which is been after conversion should be more one. So if on 1 centimeter square it is this much, 196.2. So for 1 meter square, how much will be the value is nothing but the conversion. In 1 centimeter square, that is 1 centimeter by 1 centimeter, we can convert it as 1 centimeter is 10^-2 meter, or 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So 1 centimeter square is equal to square of this term, so 10^-4. But centimeter square term is at denominator, which when comes to numerator, then in that case it becomes 10^-4. So after coming to numerator, that will become 10^-4. So this will be the multiplying factor for a pressure if we are converting it into the larger area. I think this is clear to all of you. So let's start with another conversion, bulk modulus K is equal to 19.62. K given to us as 19.62 × 10^4 Newton per centimeter square. So the value will become 19.62 × 10^4 × 10^4, that is 19.62 × 10^8 Newton per meter square. Another value, that is modulus of elasticity or Young's modulus, E is equal to 11.772 × 10^6 Newton per meter square. Newton per centimeter square. So it will become 11.772 × 10^6 × 10^4, that is equal to 11.772 × 10^10 Newton per meter square. So now we are going to use our formula for pressure calculation. P is equal to V into under root of rho upon 1 plus K plus D upon AT. Putting the values, 1000 is equal to, not known to us, rho is 1000, 1 upon K is 19.62 × 10^8 plus dia is 150 mm, × 10^-3 meter. E value is 11.772 × 10^10 into T value, thickness value is 10 mm. So 10 × 10^-3. All these things are under root sign. After solving, we will have value of V. We can calculate value of V as 1.566. Obviously, unit of velocity is in meter per second. Basically, this problem is nothing but the limiting value of velocity for a particular operating of a wall. Say, for example, if the pressure is this one 196.2. So what should be the operating discharge or operating velocity so that the wall will remain in good condition? So that is the problem. For that purpose, we are going to calculate the velocity that should be maintained. This velocity corresponds to discharge. If it is asked to calculate the discharge, then in that case we have to use the formula Q equal to AV. So if discharge is to be calculated, if discharge Q to be calculated, use formula Q equal to area into velocity. Velocity is known to us, to calculate area, we will require dia, which is known to us. So we can calculate the discharge also. That's all. Thank you.